left the parking lot here and we went out to what must have been thousands of fans, it just reinforced to myself and our players how great our fans are, how special this place is in terms of why it's different from every other place.
We come up out of the elevator and the elevator doors open and bam, there's, you know, tons of people out there. They had just enough room for us to walk through and get by because there's that many people there. We normally have, you know, some family and that out there and, you know, a lot of the support staff in the building and stuff like that around, but I've never seen anything like that before. That was awesome.
When I walked up the stairs, I heard an uproar. And it was probably with somebody or another player before me coming up, and you know, I actually thought all the crowd was you know, inside the complex. But as I got closer and closer, you know, it was kind of refreshing to see that many people, you know, that many cameras flashing at one time. It was like, you know, something that I have never seen before. Those guys were here for us as a team, and you know, it made us feel very good.
It was just a great experience to be able to walk out the day before the game in the afternoon, you know, 24 hours before the game is even going to be kicked off, and see that many people already ready and excited to see us go out and play.
Before the game, you know, from pregame meal to the bus ride back, like, this is my last everything. Tiger walk, you know, I made the best of it, you know. I really embraced the moment, you know, the fans, just, you know, how much they're there and they care for us.
The bar was raised since that point on to, you know, until the clock strikes zero in the fourth quarter. Because, you know we have some die-hard fans that are willing to do anything for us. And we have to repay them by being die-hard athletes that are willing to, you know, do anything to get a win, to make them happy.
Hey, man, y'all boy get in here, man.
Yeah.
Y'all boy get in here, man.
Yes, sir.
Like I told y'all boy wasn't here last night. I said they could do anything they want to throughout the week. But when that ball come off that boy foot, whoever kick it, us or them, they can't stop us. And there's only two words we got to say to them boy, man. We coming.
Yes,
sir. Write it down on that, man.
Oh, say it loud and proud, man. One, two, three.
We coming.
For mostly sunny. Georgia won the toss. They have deferred, so Auburn will get the ball. Blair Walsh will kick off for the Bulldogs, and we are at long last underway. DeMond Washington, number 14. Gets to the 19, maybe the 20. Dodges the first tackler and the second. Now he's got a lot of room as he comes left. Knocked out of bounds after a 13-yard gain to the 33-yard line. Akeem Dent with the tackle. Left side. This is the freshman Michael Dyer. Little pirouette in the front of the linebacker, and he spins for an additional 3 yards. That's McCaleb in motion. And
that's the way they go.
Yeah. Look for the block from McCaleb. Here's Newton. Out of bounds at the 1 yard line.
When you talk to Gus Malzahn, he said one of our favorite formations has been bringing Zimba and Mosley, 73 and 75 together. Mike Berry pulls around, and you can see Cam Newton gets it turned upfield. He's just a monster.
At the goal line, ruled out of bounds.
Cam, he's a leader. You even see it in the spring, you know, when he was battling for a position. You know, he worked hard. And, you know, the day he won that position, you know, you could tell that he was going to take a leadership role on this team.
Leadership to me is more so walking than talking. Simple and plain.
It's a lot of times people always talk their way into leadership, but I'm a firm believer, and it was instilled in me at a young age. It's better for you to lead by example rather than even saying a word.
Run with our hand. Well, hold on. Here we are.
After further review, video evidence shows that the ball carrier broke the play to the goal line prior to going out of bounds. Touchdown.
Saw the graphic, five consecutive games, 30 points plus. Murray is hit, and then he is dropped after he's hit a second time. Nosa Igwe got there. Not a sack master. That's his first full sack of the season. Play action. Oh, boy. Murray is still upright. Bates missed it, and Murray throws it away.
That was a big play.
Devin Bates had him wrapped up and did not secure the tackle.
It's the second time Bates has come from the...
Now comes in motion. Play fake, Murray. A lot of time, deep. A.J. Green, touchdown, Georgia. Heading south. Newton. They slipped it to the right side. It's Ontario McCaleb. And McCaleb can flat fly. Little nifty ball handling. There is, however, a flag back at the 35.
Yeah, it's coming back. I got a feeling.
Play action, Murray. Deep in the middle, got him open. Touchdown. Sean Chappas, there's your fullback.
I was one.
Right. Mario Fannin comes out. Here's Newton back to throw. Now he'll take off. Stiff arm. First down.
He better be careful on that one. And he got warned.
That looked like more like a right
and
jab.
It was unnecessary, too. Cam does a good job. No pressure from the San Diego State. Doing a great job there.
Fairley's back on the field. Here's Murray. Play fake. Again, he's got... all kinds of time.
One team's making the catches and one team isn't.
Well, one team has A.J. Green and the other doesn't.
This is about as bad as you can throw a crossing route.
Fairley got to Murray again. Here's Fairley, number 90.
Yeah, let's see if he drives him into the ground again.
Tackles. And he was the guy who missed one then. First down, play fake again. Murray, deep right side. A.J. Green, Demond Washington.
Oh.
Easy touchdown. Easy touchdown.
Into the game. They haven't caught their second wind yet.
Up the middle, Newton. Got him. Blake, wow. First and goal. Got inside of Rambo. Emery Blake. McCaleb trying to get around the corner, does. Touchdown, Auburn.
Camera right on the line.
Murray looks the other direction. Now, he'll run near side and shovels it out of bounds. He was outside the tackle box. Josh Bynes was chasing him. In their career here. Caleb King got him. Third down. Nick Fairley, Corey Lemonnier, number 55. Fairly having an All-American season.
He absolutely is. Drake Nevis from LSU.
Nico Thorpe is playing well back. Little inside pass is incomplete. Looks like it was intended for Caleb King, and Mike Blanc, number 93, got in there to mess things up. Fourth down. Green and Michael Johnson hooked up on the touchdown. On a fourth and 15 from the 19. Here's kick flip, and the Bulldogs won that one 24-21 to go before the break. Newton with the play fake to McCaleb. Deep left side, wide open. He's caught.
He threw that flat-footed. Oh, my goodness.
Emory Blake on the cut was open by 5 yards. That's a 25-yard gain.
Yeah, all the way across the field. Newton flat-footed just lets this thing go at the last second. Play-action pass. Timeout if they don't make it.
Georgia bringing three. Newton has it. Little stutter step. Newton first down at the 20.
That's never a bad call.
He's a weapon, isn't he?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, keep it on the ground.
Yep, keep it on the ground. The clock is going to start. Auburn has all three timeouts. If you don't make it, you're going to move it forward.
Newton still has it. Drills it in the end zone. Oh, my. Caught. Touchdown. Philip Lutzenkirchen. I was hoping I'd get to say that today.
Ladies and gentlemen, this just is not that easy to do. This is another bullet by a guy that's rushed for 100 yards in the first half. Remember, he's had a couple sacks. Gus Malzahn says, you're a freak.
Lutzenkirchen's third catch of the year for a TD.
Newton, and what it does, it draws the safety over. Look how wide the safety is. The half roll produced the seam, and that's again the design by a coach to make that play. And you know what? Comes to the sideline, Bo knows talent.
Tracy with Gene Chizik.
Thanks, Vern. Coach, you started out slow. It seemed like a lack of focus with your team and then the huge game-tying touchdown. So what was the difference in that half?
Well, I think early on our whole team was really excited. They were, you know, we were making stupid penalties, giving up some deep plays. We turned the ball over early, which is unusual for us. We just had to get our team settled down and they got to start playing.
Speaking of settling down, how about Cam and his focus after everything that's gone on this week?
Well, I think he's been really focused. You know, he's just got to continue to be more consistent this game. We got to get him a few more runs, and he's got to be able to break a few more runs. But right now, we just got to be a more consistent team.
Thank you a lot.
Thank you.
Coach, you jumped out to a 21-7 lead, but they were able to tie it to go into half. How did they get back in this game?
Well, they just made some stops on defense, and you know, they're a heck of an offensive football team. It's just a great football game right now. Good 30 minutes. Now we got to go finish.
A.J. Green, two touchdowns, 114 yards receiving. How has he been so successful so far?
Well, we've got some one-on-one matchups, and the one catch he had on fourth down was a situation that we thought we had a good shot at getting a one-on-one post and that type of deal. So Coach Bo did a good job of installing the play, repping it, and then, you know, having the nerve to call it.
Thanks a lot. Good luck in the second half. Vern?
All right, Tracy, thank you.
During the week, each game week, Coach Chizik and I, we talk about a number of different fakes that we can do to maybe steal a possession or things that we can do to help our football team out in regards to special teams. And the onside kick was one of the things that we looked at and said, hey, you know, there's an opportunity for us to get that.
You got to stay onside. You got me? You got to stay onside. All right, everybody stay onside. That's what we're going to open with. We'll go get it.
A lot of coaches don't like to roll the dice like that, but you know, Coach Chizik, he believes in us, and he knows that we can get the job done. And he feels, you know, not only in the onside kick team, but also on the defense. You know, if we didn't get it, he knew that we were going to go out there and we were going to stop him anyway.
In the defense, you guys know that we're opening up with it, okay? So no matter what happens, you guys be ready to defend it.
Coach Chizik does a great job of letting the guys know that, hey, you know, this is what we're doing. And if we don't get this, this is what you have to do. You know, you have to be ready to play defense on this side of the field and stop them.
Onside kick. You may or may not get it. Let's go play ball from the 40. Don't matter. Let's go. Let's go. We've got to get it now. Everybody onside. Remind everybody. Everybody staying onside on this sucker, man. We're going to go get this thing.
There's a lot of trust that maybe is a little hidden in there. You trust your defense that if you don't get it, they're going to stop them. You trust their offense that if they do get the ball, even if they scored, that we'll come back and we'll outscore them. There's a lot of moving parts in there when it comes to the trust factor, but I think all those played into our decision.
We're starting all over, baby. Mm-hmm. 30 minutes. 30 minutes. We're going to fix it and have some fun. Offense, we're going to get your ball back right off the start. Let's go.
Let's go, baby! Hey!
Coach Chizik really doesn't have to say much at all, you know. When he comes out there and he says that, you know, we're going to start with the onside kick team, and I have so much confidence, you know, with us, the players, and as well as the coaches, too. And it's big to have that type of confidence in your head coach.
Confidence is not a strong enough word. It's trust, you know. We trust each other as coaches. Coaches, players trust coaches. So, you know, but that doesn't happen over 6 months. That's happened over a 20-month period of time.
Exactly the way we worked it.
Let's bring it on.
Working that way, that's exactly how we worked it.
It all starts with trust first. You know, we had 11 guys out there that they were into it. They wanted to do it, and we trusted them. In terms of them executing it, it was a risk that we took. The game was basically tied up at the point, and you know, it was the opening kickoff of the half, possible momentum swings one way or the other.
Gotta make it work.
And we just trusted our guys that when we make that call, and I told them at halftime, you gotta execute it. There's no room for error. And they did exactly what we asked them to do.
Third quarter. Boykin is back, a dribble kick onside. Onside kick. Guess what? It worked.
How about that? Rolling the dice.
My gosh, how about that?
This is a Sean Payton call right here in the Super Bowl when they just rolled the dice and it worked.
Wes Byram kicked it off the top of the football, allowed it to go the 10 yards up and into his hands. I don't think there's any question. It is indeed. Zachary coming around the left side, breaks a tackle, gets a block from Cody Burns, and that gives him an extra 10 yards.
Well, you start out with an onside kick and a reverse.
That's within reach again, Luke. Matt Bushman, right side.
Same play he scored on before.
Fights for additional yardage. Conversation and speculation this week. Here's the handoff, McCaleb. Touchdown, Auburn. Ontario McCaleb. From two.
It's actually the same play that McCaleb scored earlier. Is going to come over. Watch Cody Burns here. Former quarterback gets moved out to wide receiver just enough to get in the way to make that crack right there. McCaleb turns it up.
Hand off to King. Gets a good block from Chappas, but he still picks up only three. Craig Stevens, number 46, with the stop. Here, that's Chappas, the fullback. A.J. Green in tight to the right, play action.
Here he comes.
Murray in trouble. Nosa Igwe.
Yeah, but Nick Fairley, yeah. Watch Nick Fairley on this one. They cannot block this guy. Inside, Igwe's going to get the sack. But they cannot handle, and that's what forces Murray up in the pocket.
Is the inside man. Hand off Ely up the middle. Touchdown, Georgia. Auburn and Alabama. Well,
and being number one in the country, too.
Well, yeah.
They ain't getting in if they lose a game, not this year.
McCaleb.
Jeez, this offense is... I mean, it just never stops. Under center this time. They don't do it very often. Speed sweep.
Game for Auburn. Next game against Alabama. He sets a school record. Dyer to the five.
You know, it's also happening here now. That is Auburn's 51st play.
Now, Bo Jackson came up to me and even gave me a hug, you know. I tell them congratulations, I'm ready to probably be. So it was one of those special moments for myself that I really enjoyed, and it's gonna be a moment that I could never forget.
That was a very proud moment for Michael. It says a lot about Auburn football and being selfless, and Bo being happy for him that he broke his record. And this is one of the greatest running backs that ever played the game.
Yeah, this Auburn defense, particularly the back four, has been suspect. Here's a quick toss. Michaela Smith in front with the block. Touchdown, Auburn. Eric Smith out in the open. Everybody could see him lay the clearing ball.
So nicely put together. Did you see Auburn do the quick huddle and line up?
King.
Oh, it's real man football when you run the ball now.
That was Michael Goggins. Murray is chased. Here comes Fairley. There goes the ball. It's a first down. And guess.
No, he dropped
it. Oh, he dropped it.
It might have been knocked out of his hands. This might have been a good defensive play here. I think Demetrius McNeil might have got his hand on it. Let's see. Yes, you got to give that one to the defense on that one. McNeil comes off the bench and makes the play. Defended.
Here's the field goal attempt, Blair Walsh. That's good from 28. Three wide receivers split out. Here's Newton. He's got that little hesitation.
Yeah, that's the one that, bothers me a lot when I watch Cam just kind of stutter and stand there. I wonder why people don't go after him. There's not 10, 12, 15 draftable guys on this Auburn team.
And yet they are undefeated, and here's Newton. Nice catch, Emily Blake. Out on the left side, that's another first down. Cam Newton, that's a gain of 13.
Little square out. Delivers it, nice catch. That.
Throwing the ball. Is he out of bounds? Yes, he is. So
he threw the fastball on this one. The spot.
Newton. First down, Auburn. And 10. McKayla fires it. Wide open. Lutzen Kirken for the second time. Play fake. Murray has to tuck it, shakes a tackle, hit from behind. An official goes down. Lost his helmet. Where is it? As they do, got him.
Ball's out.
From behind. Who got it? Looked like Antoine Carter with the hit, and apparently Georgia with the recovery. Hit as he lets it go. Auburn football. Atlanta's only an hour and a half away.
And Nick Fairley made the play.
Cody Burns. Cameron Newton. First down. Carries 150 yards. It's second and goal. Here's Newton. He fumbles it.
He did.
But he was across the plane. It's a touchdown. The ball got loose, but it was after Newton had scored the touchdown. Took at the beginning of the year.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It is a touchdown.
They made a decision to have Cam Newton play from the very first game.
Right.
Fairley is on the bench. sacked. It'll be third down. D4, number 95. Coach, one of the great players in Auburn history, Tracy Rocker. Now they're going to take a knee and get out of here. Well, it's an unfortunate ending to this game. But a Gatorade bath for the Auburn head coach. They are the champions of the SEC West.
To end the game, we scored six straight times. So I think when you score 7 out of your 10 possessions, that's pretty good. But if you just do your job, they can't stop us. And I think that's what everyone realized, and we did. And we ended up putting up a lot of points.
Tigers going to defeat Georgia 49-31. Auburn has won the West, and they're going to Atlanta.
Gotcha, coach!
It's come a long way in a short period of time. Coach Chizik had a plan. You know, he had a plan when he was hired, type of staff he wanted, type of players we wanted to recruit. We haven't deviated from that plan whatsoever. We haven't made any exceptions to the plan. And you know, our players have played. That's the bottom line. Our players have played and played well.
Come here, man.
Oh!
That's great.
Oh, that's why you brought me here, baby.
That's it, man. That's it.
These fans are very appreciative of this year that Gene Chizik, Cam Newton, and the rest of this Auburn team has given them.
Somehow or another, Coach Chizik and his coaching staff has an excellent way of bringing the best out of us. And that's where it starts. And with that, you know, the bar is already raised high for us to succeed.
The Tigers have won the Western Division. Auburn is now 11-0. They're going to Atlanta.